Good day students, welcome to continue part of the Mughals and the Maratha. So in the previous class we have discussed about the Mughals, so now we are going to discuss about the Marathas. Okay, so the rise of Maratha kingdom in the Deccan during 17th century, it was very important development. Yes, and it spread over the present North India. As during 17th century, Maharashtra was under the control of Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar and Adil Shah of Vijaipur. Okay, and next let us discuss about the famous king of this Marathas. His name is Shivaji. Yes, so Shivaji is very important king of the Marathas. Yes, during that time the decline of Mughal kingdom started during the reign of Aurangzeb, and there was no efficient administration. Yes, so like this so the Mughal kings became very weak. Yes, and like this the misrule of the officials was Marathwada, which was away from the capital of western edge of the empire. Yes, and farmers, traders and craftsmen were overexploited by huge taxes. Yes, and the social life was burdened with the misbehavior of officials. Yes, and it was impossible to conduct any social or religious rituals in public, and they were expected to pay tax for these peoples. Yes, and Shivaji, he was able to establish a Maratha kingdom by motivating the religious and cultural favors among the Marathas. Yes, and he was a very great king among the Marathas, and he was successful in providing efficient administration along the expansion of his kingdom. Yes, and Shivaji, he was born in Shivneri of Pune district. Yes, and his father name is Shahaji Bhosle. So he was working in Vijaipur Sultans, and his mother name is Jizabai. She was a very pious woman. Yes, and she believes in religious favor. Yes, and uprightness and honesty. Yes, and his Shivaji's gurus, his name is Dadaji Kondjev. Yes, and he taught the Shivaji's warfare and scriptures. Yes, and like this Shivaji, he achieved a proficiency in bodybuilding, fencing and horse riding with the help of Dadaji Kondjev. Yes, and in his childhood, Shivaji itself, he dreamed about establishing an independent kingdom. So therefore Pune as his center, and he started the process of expansion of his kingdom. Yes, and he he conquered Torangad fort, Purandargad fort. Yes, and Charkankot fort, Simukada. Yes, and Jawali fort. Yes, which was under the Vijaipur Sultan. Yes, so like this he achieved a great religion during his time. But Shahaji, he was working with the Vijaipur Sultan. So like this Shivaji, he is occupying some important regions of this Vijaipur Sultan. So that's why Shahaji, he was captured by the Sultans. And next, on the assurance that Shivaji would not attack on them once again, so like this, by making pact, Shahaji was released. So let us discuss about the relationship between the Mughals and Shivaji. So Shivaji, he fought against the Mughal king Aurangzeb for many years. Yes, and he also defeating Shahi kingdoms in South India. Yes, and Aurangzeb, he had determined to vanquish the Maratha kingdom completely. Yes, and to achieve this, he appointed Shahiste Khan and Jai Singh. So Jai Singh, who defeated Shivaji and made agreement Purandargad. Yes, and as per this agreement, Shivaji, he surrendered 23 forts. Yes, and 16 lakh income annually. Yes, and he promised to be loyal of the Mughals and sent 5,000 cavalry under the leadership of his son. Yes, so like this the relationship, it is very worse with the Shivaji and Mughals. And later Jai Singh, he called Shivaji to Agra to meet the Aurangzeb. Yes, and but the Aurangzeb, he did not gave the proper respect to Shivaji in his court, and he insulted by him. And when Shivaji protested against this, so Shivaji and his son Sambhaji were kept in prison in Agra. But after a few days, Shivaji along with his son, he escaped from this from that prison. Yes, and Shivaji was collecting 1/4 of tax, that is Chautha. Yes, and 1/10, that is Sir Deshmukh of tax. Yes, and in the year 1674 at Raigad, Shivaji coronation took place. Yes, and let us discuss about the administration of Shivaji. So Shivaji, he had organized an efficient administration. Yes, and his kingdom, it was divided into provinces like Mughal empires. Yes, and Marathi, it was the administration language of Marathas. Yes, and the Ashtapradhans was there to assist the king. Yes, in addition, there were some officials were there, and provinces and districts and villages is also there. So revenue system. So revenue system, they are collecting 1/4 and 1/10 of tax. Okay, and judiciary system. So Shivaji, he has an administration tradition system of justice in was in practice. So there were village panchayat was there to dispense the justice in villages. Yes, and Brahmin judges were there. Yes, and army. Yes, so cavalry was there, infantry was there, elephant units are there. Yes, and cannon units are there. Yes, and some important forts we found in Marathwada, that is Raigad, Rajgad, Torangad, Pratapgad. These are the important fort constructed by Shivaji. Okay, and let us discuss about the successor of Shivaji. So when Shivaji, he was on his deathbed, so quarrels arose between the wives of Sai Bai Sambhaji, that is Sai Bai, she was a mother of Sambhaji, and Soira Bai Shirke, she was the mother of Rajaram, Rajarams. Yes, so Sambhaji, by his strength, he conquered Maratha kingdom and began his region, and he lacked vision and wisdom. But due to this, instead of protecting his kingdom, he himself became the victim of Aurangzeb's army, and his wife and young son Sahu were captured. Yes, and thus Sambhaji's stepbrother, his name is Rajaram, he became the royal representative of Sahu and took over the administration. And next, Rajaram, who fought against the Mughals, again recaptured Gujarat, Malwa and Berar. Yes, and since Rajaram died in 1700, her wife Tarabai Mohite, she came to power, and she served as the royal representative from 1700 to 1708. And she also waged war against the Aurangzeb. Yes, and next, Aurangzeb's successor Bahadur Shah I, who released Sambhaji's son Sahu from prison, and he permitted him to collect the Chauth and Sardeshmukhi taxes from Mughal lands. And this led to internal strife between Tarabai Sahu, Tarabai and Sahu, and Tarabai gave up. And lastly, the Sahu was not competent enough, and he handed over the administration to Peshwa, that is Prime Minister. Okay, so let us discuss about the Peshwa. Yes, so Balaji Vishwanath, he was the first Peshwa, that is the first Prime Minister. Yes, and he played a decisive role in successfully getting Sahu and his mother free from captivity of Mughals. Yes, and the next one is Bajirao I. So after the death of Balaji Vishwanath, his eldest son, his name is Bajirao, he got appointed as a Peshwa. Yes, and but during that time he was only 19 years old. Yes, and with the intention of expanding of Maratha kingdom in North India, he conquered Gujarat, Malwa. Yes, and he got the collecting that is Chauth and Sardeshmukhi taxes, and later he invaded Chitradurga, Srirangapatna of Karnataka. Yes, so like this, Bajirao, he was also very important person. Yes, next one is Balaji Bajirao. Yes, so so he was only 20 years old. Yes, and Balaji Bajirao appointed his close relative Sadashiv Bau to guide him as an administration. Yes, and he aspired to enhance the image of the Marathas. Yes, and he took measures to improve the economic state of the kingdom. Yes, and also to establish a Maratha ruler over Bundelkhand, he traveled with the armies of Holkar and Sindhia in the year 1742. And next one is Mahadev Rao I. So he was considered as the second son of Balaji Rao. Yes, and he became the Peshwa after the death of his father. And since he was a minor, he appointed his uncle, as a royal representative. Okay, and after the defeat of third battle of Panipat, he recovered in an astonishing manner and established his kingdom in South and North India. Yes, so like this, Mahadev Rao re-established the lost glory of the Marathas in a very short period, and after the British routed the Marathas in the third Anglo-Maratha war, and Maratha ruler almost came to end. So thank you for watching this video, and I hope all of you have understood this. Thank you.